Okay, how many of you come with expectation today? Amen? Hallelujah. How many of you believe that the Lord is speaking to us through every service? Amen? Hallelujah. Okay, John chapter 15, verse 16. John chapter 15, verse 16. Someone can read. You did not choose me.
But I choose you and appointed you that you should go and bear fruit and that your fruit should remain, that whatever you ask the Father in my name, he may give you.
Amen. Hallelujah. You did not choose me, but I chose you and appointed you that you should go and bear fruit and that your fruit should remain, that whatever you ask the Father in my name, he may give you. Here Jesus told the disciples, you did not choose me, but I chose you. Hallelujah. Today I'm going to talk to you about a life of a chosen vessel. What God will do in the life of chosen vessel. Amen. Jesus said, I have chosen you. Amen. Hallelujah. How many of you believe that God has chosen you? Amen. We can read the verse again. Bible says, he chose us with a purpose. Here Jesus told the disciples, I chose you and appointed you that you should go and bear fruit. Amen. Hallelujah. First purpose, you should go. Amen. Hallelujah. That means what is that? You should go means what is that? You are not supposed to stuck in one place. The Lord doesn't like a stagnant in our life. Amen. The stagnant water will sting. How many of you believe that? Amen. It has to move. It has to go forward. Hallelujah. Amen. God has called us to go out. Amen. Why we need to go out? To bear fruit. Hallelujah. There is a purpose in every chosen's life. Hallelujah. Amen. Here God is clearly telling the disciples, you should go and bear fruit, and your fruit should remain, that whatever you ask the Father in my name, he may give you. Hallelujah. Amen. When you do all this thing, then the Lord will do his part. Hallelujah. When you go and when you bear fruit, then whatever you ask, that the Father will give you. Hallelujah. Amen. When you go by obedience, then the Lord will work along with you. Amen. Hallelujah. Okay, tell your neighbor, you are a chosen vessel. Amen. There is a purpose in your life. Amen. Hallelujah. There is a purpose in your life. Amen. Hallelujah. Do you believe that? Amen. Hallelujah. The Lord will never do things without purpose. Hallelujah. If you're born in this world, there is a purpose. Hallelujah. When Jesus came to this world, he came with a purpose. Amen. He fulfilled his purpose. Because he fulfilled his purpose, we all alive today. We all blessed through his purpose. Amen. Through your purpose, the people will be blessed. Amen. God has chosen you as a vessel of blessing. Amen. The Lord wants you to be a blessing to someone. Amen. Here Jesus told the disciples, you need to go and bear fruit. Amen. That means through your fruit, people will be blessed. Amen. Our life needs to be a life of fruitfulness. Hallelujah. God has called us to give fruit. Amen. Hallelujah. In Connecticut, I was sharing about the blessings of the Lord. Amen. One of the blessings is to be a fruitful people. Amen. Hallelujah. When God blessed Sarah, God told Abraham, I will bless her and she will bear a son. Amen. When God blesses, our barrenness will turn into fruitfulness. Amen. The one of the reasons the Lord is blessing our life is to be a fruitful person. Amen. Hallelujah. How many of you have a garden in your life, in your house? Amen. Yes. Okay. At least small garden, right? You will expect that tree to give fruit. Otherwise, you will be disappointed, right? Right? In my house, it's a big struggle to see a fruit. Amen? Every day we are praying. Hallelujah. Amen? Because when the tree gives fruit, it will give joy to the master. Amen? When your life gives fruit, it will bring joy to Jesus. Hallelujah. That's why Jesus said, I have chosen you with a purpose. Amen? Hallelujah. Okay, what the Lord will do in a chosen people's life. That is the message I told you already. Okay, we are going to see a couple of people's life. What God did in the chosen people's life. The first thing the Lord will do, it's a separation. Amen? Chosen people's life. The Lord will separate them from certain things. Amen? The first separation the Lord will do it, the Lord will separate them from their comfort zone. Hallelujah. Which we do not like it. Amen? But He will do it. Hallelujah. Genesis chapter 37, verse 13. Genesis chapter 37, verse 13. And Israel said to Joseph, come, I will send you to them. Here I am. Here we see that a father sent his son to his brothers. Amen. Come and I will send you to them. So he said to him, here I am. Hallelujah. This is the conversation between Jacob and Joseph, or Israel and Joseph. Hallelujah. Amen. Joseph was a chosen vessel. Here God and the father said, come and I will send you to them. So he said to him, here I am. Amen. Hallelujah. No postpone, no second option, no second opinion, no more question, nothing. Hallelujah. Amen. Sometimes you will, you want me to go? First question. You want me to go now? Second question. Why don't next week? Yes. Yes or no? Amen. We will try to postpone it. We'll try to delay it. We'll try to refuse it. But here, Joseph is a chosen vessel. He immediately obeyed. Amen. Hallelujah. The Lord will expect obedience from the chosen vessel. Amen. Tell your neighbor, you are a chosen vessel. Amen. He will expect you to obey. Amen. Hallelujah. Okay. Did you tell them? Okay. Tell them one more time. Don't give you excuse. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Here, the father asked him to go. He said, yes, here I am. 37:3. What was the good thing Joseph had in his life? 37:3.
Now Israel loved Joseph.
Now Israel loved Joseph more than all his children. Amen. Hallelujah. He had a father's love. Because he was the son of his old age, also he made him a tunic of many colors. He had a father's love and he had father's favor, favorite child. Amen. Because he was born in his old age, he got that favor. Hallelujah. Amen. He was very comfortable with his father's love. He was very comfortable with his father's favor. What happens to him? Okay, 37:4.
But when his brothers saw that their father loved him more than all his brothers, they hated him and could not speak peaceably to him.
Amen. When his brothers saw that their father loved him more than all his brothers, they hated him. Amen. Hallelujah. The chosen vessel got the favor. The chosen vessel, this chosen vessel got the favor, got the love, but also he got the enmity. Because of the love of father, he got the enmity. But to those people, now the father is sending Joseph to that place. Amen. Whoever hates them, among them, the father wants to send Joseph. Amen. Hallelujah. It's not the right people. They are not the right place. That's why I said God will remove us from the comfort zone and the Lord will help. Lord will expect us to go to the uncomfortable zone. Amen. Hallelujah. It will happen in the life of chosen people. Amen. Many times we want to be in the comfortable zone. We don't want to move away, not even 1 inch from our comfortable zone. Amen. I am comfortable this place. I am very comfortable. Don't disturb me. But here, the Father is disturbing Joseph's comfort zone. Hallelujah. Because he was a chosen vessel. Amen. We can read a couple of verses about the brothers, how they were. Verse 5.
Now Joseph had a dream and he told it to his brothers and they hated him even more.
Amen. First, Joseph had a love of father and favor of father. Then Joseph had a dream. Because of that dream, they hated him even more. Hallelujah. We can read verse 8.
And his brothers said to him,
shall
you indeed reign over us or shall you indeed have dominion over us? So they hated him even more for his dreams and for his words.
So they hated him even more for his dreams and for his words. He got some dreams from the Lord and he shared the dreams to his brothers. Because of the dream, because of the words he shared the dream, they hated him even more. Amen. Hallelujah. Okay, verse 11.
And his brothers envied him, but his father kept the matter in mind.
Amen. The brothers envied him. Okay. If you see the place of Joseph, he did not do anything to have this enmity. He did not do anything to have this jealousy. Okay. The love of Jacob, love of Israel, it came from his father. Joseph did not do anything, right? He did not do any mistake or any fault to get the enmity. The father loved him. The father gave the quote, favor, right? Because of that, he got the enmity. The dream came from the Lord. Joseph did not do anything. The Lord gave the dream. Because of the dream, he got the enmity. Amen. Hallelujah. Because of the favor, because of the love, because of the purpose in his life, they got jealousy. Amen. Joseph did not do anything. Sometimes, if you are a chosen vessel, you need to go through this path even though you are not doing anything for that. We are wondering many times, right? Why I am going through all this? Why people are hating me? Why people are jealous over my life? What I did? Hallelujah. What I did to them? Many times we are having this question. Why I am going through this? What I did? Amen. You don't need to do anything to have all this. Amen. Hallelujah. Because of his purpose, because of God's purpose upon the life of Joseph, Joseph went through all these things. Hallelujah. He went through enmity. He went through jealousy. Hallelujah. Amen. Bible says the father Israel sent Joseph to this people only. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. If you are in that place of Joseph, maybe you give an option to Israel, Jacob. Send me to someone else, not to this people. I can go and do ministry to anyone, not to this people, right? But Bible says, sometime the Lord will do like that. Hallelujah. The Lord will ask you to go wherever you don't want to go. Amen. It's very hard for you to do, but the Lord will ask you to do. Hallelujah. The Lord will ask you to stick on to that place, but you don't want to stick on to that place. Hallelujah. You don't want to talk to someone, but the Lord will ask you, go, humble yourself, talk to that person. Amen? Hello? Amen? We don't want to be moved from our comfort zone. But this morning, the Lord wants you to go away from your comfort zone. Then only you can bear fruit. Then only you can see the purpose of God is fulfilling in and through your life. Amen? Hallelujah. But here Bible says, Joseph immediately obeyed. Here I am. Hallelujah. The first step the Lord is expecting from chosen vessel to say that, here I am. Lord, I am available for you. Hallelujah. I know I am chosen. I know I am a separated one. I know that you have a purpose in my life. Doesn't matter how much it's difficult, doesn't matter how much it's discomfort zone, I want to do. I want to go. Hallelujah. Amen. Today, are you willing? If the Lord asks you to do something, are you willing to do? Hallelujah. Amen. Hello. Okay, how many of you have dreams, visions? Amen. How many of you want to be used by the Lord? Amen. How many of you want to be blessed by God? How many of you want to be a blessing to someone? Amen. Then you need to come out of the comfort zone. You need to be willing. You need to say, here I am. Amen. Hallelujah. Joseph knew my brothers are not liking me. They do not like me. My brothers are having enmity over me. My brothers are having jealous over my life. But my father is asking me to go to that place. Amen. Hallelujah. But if the Lord says something, he has purpose in that. Amen. Hallelujah. If you read 1 Samuel chapter 17, verse 17 and 18. Here we can see another chosen vessel, David. Then Jesse said to his son David, take now for your brothers an ephah of this dried grain and these 10 loaves and run to your brothers at the camp. Next verse. And carry these 10 cheeses to the captain of the 1,000 and see how your brothers fare and bring back news of them. Amen. Hallelujah. All of a sudden, the life of David was changing from this point. The father asked David to go to your brothers. Amen. Hallelujah. Later on, we all know that the brothers did not like David was in the battlefield. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. But the father asked him to go. Verse 20. Say, David rose early in the morning, left the sheep with the keeper and took the things and went as Jesse had commanded him. Amen. Hallelujah. David knew this is a command from my father. Amen. Joseph knew this is the will of my father. Amen. Sometime there is no option in our hand. Amen. The Lord will give you command. You need to go. Hallelujah. Amen. There is a difference between two. Command and giving options. Sometimes the Lord will give you free will. Amen. Sometimes the Lord will demand you. Hallelujah. Here Bible says David did as the father commanded. Hallelujah. Chosen vessel needs to understand there are some commandments from my father. There is no option in my hand, but I am supposed to do that. I am called to do that. Hallelujah. Amen. Then Jesus told the disciples, stay in Jerusalem until you receive the power from above. Hallelujah. It's a commandment. It's an order. Bible says disciples did that. As soon as Jesus ascended to the heaven, they all came to Jerusalem. They found a house. They went upon the house. They were waiting. Amen. Hallelujah. There is no option in it. Amen. Today the Lord wants to encourage us to do certain things as he commands us. Amen. Hallelujah. The instruction is coming from above to the chosen vessel. But we need to understand you are called to do that. Amen. Hallelujah. No option in your side. No, don't mix up your ideas with God's ideas. If the Lord asks you to do, do it. Amen. You need to say, Lord, I am willing to do. I don't want to mix my ideas with your ideas. Amen. Sometimes our ideas will be good, but it's not according God's will. Later on, I am going to talk to you about that also. Moses, Bible talks about Moses, Exodus 3, verse 10. Exodus 3, verse 10. Come now, therefore, and I will send you to Pharaoh that you may bring my people, the children of Israel, out of Egypt. Exodus chapter 2, verse 15. We can read Exodus chapter 2, 15. Here the Lord is asking Moses to go to Pharaoh. But Bible says, Moses feared of this Pharaoh and he came out of this Egypt. When Pharaoh heard of this matter, he sought to kill Moses. But Moses fled from the face of Pharaoh and dwelt in the land of Midian, and he sat down by a well. Already Pharaoh was planning to kill Moses, but the Lord is asking him to go back to that place. Amen. Do you understand the discomfort zone for Moses? Do you understand the discomfort zone for David? Do you understand the discomfort zone for Joseph? Hallelujah. But we need to believe that our Heavenly Father will never make mistake in our life. If you are a chosen vessel, whatever it happens in your life, it's for your good. Amen. The Lord wants to fulfill all His purpose and plans through your life. Amen. Hallelujah. But the Lord is expecting us to willing to obey. Hallelujah. When you obey, the Lord will make the discomfort zone as a blessed zone for you. Amen. Hallelujah. That will happen in our life. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. It happened in the life of Joseph. It happened in the life of Moses. It happened in the life of David also. Amen. Hallelujah. What God did in the life of Moses, God asked him to go. He scared to go back. He refused to go. Actually, he was argued with God. But the Lord said, I will be with you. Then I will be with your mouth. You go. Then God said, Exodus chapter 4, verse 19. Exodus chapter 4, verse 19. We can read that verse.
Go return to Egypt. For all the men who sought your life are dead.
Amen. Hallelujah. Go return to Egypt. For all the men who sought your life are dead. That's why I said, when you are willing to obey to His call, He will clear the path for you. Amen. It looks like it's a discomfort zone. Lord, He is seeking to kill me. He is looking for me. Amen. But what the Lord did, Moses, you are ready to go, right? I will clear the path. Hallelujah. God said, go return to Egypt, for all the men who sought your life are dead. This part, God alone can do it. Amen. When you are willing to go out of your discomfort zone, go out of your comfort zone, then the Lord will change the discomfort zone into a blessed zone. God told Moses, Moses, I clear the path. Don't worry. You are worried about Pharaoh, right? I will clear the path. Amen. If you are worried about your manager, I will clear the path. Amen. What are you worried about? I will clear the path. But I expect you to obey to my voice. Amen. Do not mix up your ideas. Do not mix up your thoughts. Amen. Hallelujah. Just do what I'm asking you to do. Hallelujah. Amen. Okay. Now we can read verse in Exodus. First Samuel chapter 17 verse 29. Later on, David realized there is a reason. David said, what I have done now, is there not a cause? The father sent David to the battlefield, but he realized there is a reason for it. Amen. We all know the story. That battlefield took him to the palace. Amen. That was the gateway for David to enter into the purpose of God. The Lord has chosen him as a king. Amen. If he needs to enter into the palace to become a king, there should be a way. Amen. What kind of way God did for David? The battlefield. Amen. Hallelujah. God transformed him, or God transferred him from shepherd field to battlefield. Amen. From comfort zone to discomfort zone. But this comfort zone became a blessed zone for David. Amen. People all sang, Saul killed 1,000, David killed 10,000. Actually, he killed only one man. Hallelujah. He just killed one person. But how much credit he got? 10,000. Why? He was willing to go out of his comfort zone. He was willing to obey to his father's voice. Hallelujah. If you are a chosen vessel, you have to obey to your father's voice. You are willing to go out of your comfort zone to the discomfort zone, then there you can see a blessing. Amen. Many times we will very much hesitate to do that. Hallelujah. Amen. How can I go there? Amen. My brothers are already have enmity over me. My brothers already have jealous over me. They will kill me. How can I go there? Hallelujah. But if the Father is asking you to do something, He will make everything favor to you. Amen. Hallelujah. We can come back to the life of Joseph. Genesis chapter 37 verse 18. 37:18. He obeyed to his father and he went to see his brothers. Okay, what happens there?
And six branches came out of
No, Genesis 37:18. Man. Now when they saw him afar off, even before he came near them, they conspired against him to kill him. Hallelujah. Good brothers. Amen. Hallelujah. When they saw him, immediately what kind of plan they had? Kill him. Today is the golden day for us. Let us finish him. Amen. Hallelujah. It's a right chance, right opportunity to finish his life. Hallelujah. See, that's why I already told you, God will send you to this type of people. Amen. Many times you will wonder, right? Why God is allowing all this? Why God is putting me like this? Amen. The only reason, you are a chosen vessel. Amen. Hallelujah. But what God did to Joseph, we can see next verse. Verse 19
then
and
20.
Then they
said to one another, look, this dreamer is coming.
And next verse, 20.
Therefore, let us now kill him and cast him into some pit. And we will say, some wild beast has devoured him. We shall see what will become of his dreams.
What will become of his dreams? The evil plan the brothers did, it's against his dream and his future. Because he told to his brothers, I saw this dream, you all will bow down and you all will worship me like that, right? Actually, the dream came from the Lord. Amen. If people works against you, remember that they are not working against you, they are working against the purpose of God in your life. If you are a chosen vessel, if someone do like this, the Lord will take it as his things. Amen. Hallelujah. They are not working against you. They are working against a chosen vessel of God. You are a God's vessel. Amen. They are working against God's vessel. Amen. Hallelujah. They are working against the plan of God upon your life. Amen. God will never let the things go out from his hand. Amen. That's why I said, we read it during the time of worship, our times are in God's hand. Our future is in God's hand. God will not allow the people to take away the future from your hand. Amen. If you are a chosen vessel, people will plan against you. But the hand of God will be upon you. Amen. Hallelujah. We can read the verse, the same chapter, verse 21 and 22.
But Reuben heard it. And he delivered him out of their hands and said, let us not kill him.
Amen. And Reuben heard it and he said, let us not kill him. Reuben said to them,
shed no blood, but cast him into this pit which is in the wilderness and do not lay a hand on him, that he might deliver him out of their hands and bring him back to his father.
Amen. Hallelujah. See, first everybody planned to kill him. But God changed one person's heart from the crooked people. Amen. Hallelujah. That's why I said, when you are willing to obey, you will see the favor of God. Hallelujah. God will raise some Reuben for us. Amen. Hallelujah. Reuben also, one among the brothers, when they were planned to kill him. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. You can switch the camera to the verse. Hallelujah. Amen. Bible says, Reuben suddenly said, why we need to kill him? Amen. Joseph did not do anything. Joseph did not ask Reuben, but Reuben himself offered this. God alone can change the hearts of the people. When you are willing to obey to his voice, if you are a chosen vessel, the Lord will change the people's heart. Hallelujah. Reuben thought, let me save my brother and bring him back to my father. Hallelujah. So he gave idea, let us not shed the blood, but let us throw him in the pit. Hallelujah. Amen. We can read the next verse. Mm.
So it came to pass when Joseph had come to his brother that they stripped Joseph of
verse 20. Okay. You can read.
That they stripped Joseph of his tunic, the tunic of many color that was on him. Then they took him and cast him into a pit, and the pit was empty. There was no water in it. And they sat down to eat a meal. Then they lifted their eyes and looked, and there was a company of Ishmaelites.
Okay. Now I want to ask you one question. Reuben's plan is good or not? Reuben's idea. It's a good idea to save his life. But it's not a God's idea. Amen? Hallelujah. Sometimes some plans will be good, but it's not aligned with God's plan. Amen? God's plan is not to take him back to his father. God's plan is he has to go to Egypt. Amen? Sometimes in our chosen people's life, the plans look good, but we need to check whether it's God's plan or Reuben's plan. Amen? Hallelujah. We all think, hey, Reuben is a very nice brother. He's a good brother. Whatever he says, it will be good all the time. Yes? But it's not supposed to be. Sometimes it looks good, but it's not the best plan. It's not the plan of God. Amen? If you read the same chapter, you can read continuously, brother.
And they sat down to eat a meal. Then they lifted their eyes and looked. There was a company.
How cruel they are, right? Throw him in the pit, they are eating outside. Amen? Hallelujah. That is brothers. That is sisters. Amen? Hallelujah. Throw one person, keep a party with other people. Hallelujah. That is the world. Amen? Bible recorded everything. Okay? Don't wonder about all these things. If those things happen to Joseph, it will happen to you also. Amen. Hallelujah. Reuben also there. Right? Who gave a good plan. Now he is eating. Amen. Okay. So don't appreciate Reuben all the time. Don't think that Reuben is always good. Who is Reuben in your life? Who is giving good ideas to you? Don't trust on Reuben's. Amen. Reuben's ideas may be good for you, but it's not God's plan. Hallelujah. They may be your brother, they may be your sister. You think if Reuben says, some people I know that, you know, sometimes they used to say, if that person says, always it is good. No. They are working against God's plan. They are giving you nice ideas, but you need to find out whether it's from God or from Reuben. Amen? Hallelujah. You need to show love to your brother Reuben. But you are not called to follow Reuben's ideas. Amen? Pit, maybe you think pit is a safe place for me. Pit may be a comfortable zone for you from shedding blood. But we are called to do God's plans. Amen? Hallelujah. That's why God raised one Judah in that place. We can read that.
Then they lifted their eyes and looked, and there was a company of Ishmaelites coming from Gilead with their camels bearing spices, balm, myrrh, on their way to carry them down to Egypt. So Judah said to his brother, what profit is there if we kill our brother and conceal his blood? Come and let us sell him to the Ishmaelites. Let not our hand be upon him, for he is our brother and our flesh. And his brother listens. Then Midianite traders passed by. So the brothers pulled Joseph up and lifted him out of the pit and sold him to the Ishmaelites for 20 shekels of silver. And they took Joseph to Egypt.
Amen. That is the original plan of God. If you read Psalm 105, Bible talks about the plan of Joseph. God sent one man long time before to feed his people when they are going through famine. Amen. Hallelujah. God, the plan of God is to protect his nation. For that, God chose this one man. God put this one man in the discomfort zone. Amen. Hallelujah. The nice plans are coming against God's plan. But God overcame all the people's plan. Amen. Today, the Lord wants to overcome all the people's plan in your life. Amen. God has called you to do his plan, not anyone's ideas. Amen. Hallelujah. Here, Judah said, let us sell him to that person. Already I told you one time when I was sharing about the life of Joseph, God brought the Ishmaelites, the business people, at the right time. Amen. I do not know how many days before they started their journey. Amen. God ordained everything. If you are aligned with the will of God, if you are aligned with the original plan of God, the Lord will bring the right people at the right time. You don't need to worry about it. Hallelujah. See, this situation, there was nothing under the control of Joseph. Everything is going out of Joseph's control. Right? Joseph did not have any option to cry out to his brother. Joseph did not give any ideas to his brother. He did not have any control. I mean, sometimes in your life also, situation will go like that. You are thinking everything is going out of my control. Amen. But if you are a chosen vessel, if you are aligned with the will of God, you don't need to worry about the situations. God will keep everything under his control. Amen. The only one thing we need to realize, we need to check whether I am aligned with the will of God. Hallelujah. If you are aligned with the plan of God, then God will bring the right people at the right time. Amen. God brought them to this, to that place. God brought that business people to that place. When Judah saw that, God gave that idea to Judah. My son, Joseph has to do my will. Hallelujah. Sell him. Hallelujah. So Bible says they took him, they sold him to that business people. Hallelujah. Amen. Now, they took him to the Egypt. Once he went to Egypt, he saw the favor of God. Amen. Hallelujah. Already I told you that many times before, I think I told you, Egypt was a new place for Joseph. It's not a familiar zone. Amen. But he saw the hand of God. Bible says as soon as he went to Egypt, the first time Bible says, Genesis chapter 39:2. Genesis 39:2.
The Lord was with Joseph, and he was a successful man, and he was in the house of his master, the Egyptian.
Amen. The first place Bible says in the life of Joseph, the Lord was with Joseph. Where he was with Joseph? In his unfamiliar place, in his discomfort zone. The Lord was with Joseph. Amen. Hallelujah. And also Bible says, and he was a successful man, and he was in the house of his master, Egyptian. The Egyptian. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. God will keep you as a successful man and successful woman, you know, in your discomfort zone. Hallelujah. Maybe you think it's a new field. I have no idea. Amen. Sometimes, you know, your managers will ask you to do a new thing which you never... No. Hallelujah. You are not at all familiar with that skill set. They will ask you to do it. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. They will tell you, you can do it. I know you can do it. Amen. Sometimes I will also tell people, you can do it. I know you can do it. Right? Later on, if you see that, they will become a successful people in that area. Amen. But first we will hesitate. We will say, no, I cannot do. Amen. Hallelujah. But Joseph became a successful man in the new land. Amen. Hallelujah. How many of you believe that? Amen. But you need to go out. You need to do whatever the Lord is asking you to do. Then only you can see the hand of God. then only you can see the favor of God. Hallelujah. Amen. If Joseph was in his father's place continuously, maybe he took care of some sheep continuously. His life will stuck in the shepherd field. But the plan of God is to keep him above, not below. Amen. To keep him as a head, not tail. But he had to go through all this thing. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Bible says he became a successful man. And we can read chapter, same chapter, verse 3.
And his master saw that the Lord was with him. And that the Lord made all he did to prosper in his
hand. Master saw that the Lord was with him and that the Lord made all he did to prosper in his hand. Amen. Hallelujah. The Lord will open the eyes of the people to see that the Lord is with you.
Amen.
Hallelujah. God has to do that. Joseph did not go and tell, hey, do you know the Lord is with me? Did you see that? Because of me. He did not say all these things. But God did it. Amen. God will open the eyes of the people to see something good in you. God has to do it. When God will do it? When you are aligned with the will of God. When you are aligned with the plan of God. When you go out from your comfort zone, then only you can see the hand of God. Then only God will open the eyes of the people. Amen. Hallelujah. Many times we are asked, we are praying, right? Jesus, speak to my boss. Let him understand that I am doing good things, right? Hallelujah. It's a good prayer. But God has to open their eyes. God will do it because you are a chosen vessel. The time will come, the Lord will open their eyes, they will understand the Lord is with you. Whatever you do, it's prosper. Next verse, we can read the next verse.
So Joseph found favor in his sight and served him. Then he made him overseer of his house. And all that he had, he put under his authority.
Amen. See, God is giving him authority. Hallelujah. God is putting him as a leader. God is bringing slowly God is bringing one by one under his control. Once he was having no control, but now he started to have a control. Amen. He was not having any control over his brothers, but now he's having control over the foreigners. Amen. Who can do all these things? Only our God can do it. When he can do it, when you are willing to go out of your comfort zone. Do not give excuse to the Lord. Don't give excuse. Amen. Hallelujah. Don't delay your plans. Amen. Many times we are the reason for delaying the plans of God in our life. We are thinking God is delaying it. No, actually we are. Hello? Amen? Next verse, we can read the next verse.
So it was from the time that he had made him an overseer of his house and all that he had, that the Lord blessed the Egyptian's house for Joseph's sake.
Amen. That the Lord blessed the Egyptian house for
Joseph's sake.
And the blessing of the Lord was on all that he had in the house.
And in the field.
Amen. Hallelujah. Who was the reason for the blessing? Joseph was the reason. And also he knew because of him, the Lord is blessing my house. Hallelujah. Amen. Once they know that, they will never leave you. They will never allow you to go. If you want to resign also, they will say, no, no, we'll give you a nice package. Be here. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. They know the company is running because of you. Amen. God can do all these things if you are a chosen vessel. If you are willing to align with the plan of God, God will do it. Amen. Hallelujah. People need to think, I don't want to leave this person. Amen. Hallelujah. I want to hold. Amen. Because he is having something in his life. Because of him, I am blessed. Because of her, I am blessed. Amen. Who can do all these things? Only our God can do it. When he can do it, when you are willing to go out. And when you are willing to go out of your comfort zone and say, Lord, here I am. Use me. Amen. Here I am. Let your will alone be done in my life. Let your purpose alone be fulfilled in and through my life. Amen. Hallelujah. Then you don't need to struggle for your future. Joseph did not have any struggle for his future. Hallelujah. Amen. Maybe he went through the discomfort zone, but his path was very smooth actually. Hello. Amen. Promotion automatically came. Power automatically came. Amen. Is it smooth or no? Without asking, everything is coming. Amen. For some promotion, we need to struggle for like 3 years. We need to pray and struggle, right? Hello. Amen. But Joseph's life was going through different places, like Egypt, prison, different places. But the Lord was there. Amen. Lord turned every evil into good. Amen. Hallelujah. The Lord will open the eyes of your boss. Amen. They will understand you are carrying the presence of God. Amen. Hallelujah. If you are a chosen vessel, just keep yourself to the will of God. Amen. To the plan of God. Hallelujah. Later on, Bible says, in the prison, the Lord started to operate spiritual gift through Joseph's life. Amen. Hallelujah. If you are a chosen vessel, the Lord wants to release his spiritual gifts. Amen. He started to interpret the dreams of people. Amen. It's something from above. Amen. It's not human thing. It's God's thing. He said, God is the one interpreting the dreams. I am not. Hallelujah. When that gift was operated? When he was in the prison. That gift was not operated in his life when he was in his father's land. Amen. When you come out of your comfort zone, then only you can see the gifts of God operating in your life. Hallelujah. Amen. So you want me to finish? Many of you giving hard look. Hallelujah. Today's message is come out of your comfort zone. That is the key. Amen. Many times we will miss the key. We will take the blessings. Oh, the Lord will keep me above. The Lord will keep me like Joseph. The Lord will keep me, do all these things as he did in the life of Joseph. But we will miss the key coming out of the comfort zone. First step, come out of your comfort zone. Amen. Whichever you look, whichever it looks very comfort, come out of it. Hallelujah. That is the first step. Otherwise, this message is no use. Amen. You cannot go to the step 3 without stepping on to step 1. First of all, you need to come to step 1. Then only God will take you to step 10. Don't try to go to step 10 from here. You will have a big fall. Amen. Step 1. Come out of your comfort zone. Shall we stand together? Hallelujah. And also come out of Reuben's plans. Some of you keeping some Reubens in your life. You need to come out of Reuben's ideas. Amen. Hallelujah. Okay, let's pray.